I just love this shaft. But I'm about to introduce to you my second round of the Tarheel Golf Pride Tour Championship. This is going to be my second round, where I shot a 77, 6 over par. You guys know as well as I know that you can have good rounds and bad rounds, and you know when you play good. And sometimes when you play good, you can have a bad round, and sometimes when you play bad, you can have a good round. Well, in this case, I had a bad round. Well, I didn't play bad. I actually struck it, I think, the best I've ever struck it. And I feel like I played great. I just didn't score because I had 36 putts instead of my usual 30. That saw me shooting a 77 instead of a 71. But you just have those days. Can't predict that. Make sure you guys stick around after the video to see me being presented with the Tarheel Tour MVP and Player of the Year awards.
Well, good afternoon again. We start the second and final round with Karl sharing the lead with two other players. Again, I've missed the first couple of shots while I was attending to some things, but it's basically a Xerox of the first round. Karl's literally within a yard or so of where he was for two yesterday on the first hole, par 5, 635 yards. Karl again will have just on 100 yards to the pin. Pins at the front. So we'll see how we go today. It's a nice day in Pinehurst.
As most of you guys know, my cameraman slash dad has been late to most of my rounds these days. He's getting old, and he's leaving me to my own devices on the very first hole. This tournament, he was late on my first two shots on the first hole, both rounds. So, first two shots, it's a 630-yard par 5. There's water on the right. If I go down the hill, I will most likely run into the water, so I hit a club that will not get to that dip, which would be a 3-wood. And if I get that 250, that'll stay at the top. I hit 3-wood, 3-wood, so 3-wood to the middle, and there's a water pond thing, and then there's more fairway that goes out, and I just hit a 3-wood up there, leave myself 100 yards, hit a wedge shot, but those two shots were just 3-woods for position, and worked off at par both days.
Alright, Karl's third shot, he hit 3-wood off the tee, so as to take that lake out of play that you can see behind him. He's then hit another 3-wood to here, to leave himself 100. Pins at the front. If he leaves it short, it's not really problematic. He likes this. It's got about 10 feet for birdie. Oh, it's not going to get there. You can see how bumpy the greens are. The bumps take the speed off the putt. Right, the second hole's a par 3. Today it's playing 181 yards. Bit of a tailwind coming left to right. So Karl's probably got a 6-iron in hand here. Not overly happy with it. Oh, that's disgusting. It's 10 feet from the hole. I'd like to know what it takes to make Karl happy. More and more players using push carts these days because they realise it gives them a lot more energy to expend on their golf swing rather than lugging a bag around that could weigh 25-30 pounds. So Karl wasn't happy with that tee shot. Oh, I'd be ecstatic. starts to break quite hard right to left as it gets up to the hole. Didn't break much of it, basically held its line. These greens are very bumpy. Well, hold. Carl's even after the first two holes. Boys have found the greens a little bit bumpy. There's been a few three putts amongst the group. Starts us out to the right. It looked like it was going left. It sort of looked like it shut his club face on it a bit. Hopefully he's okay. Right, Carl's going to hit first. 145 out, bit of hurt with the breeze. Yeah, this wind's come up after he's hit it, so it's come up a couple of clubs short.
Big gust.
Yep.
Right as he hit it.
So Carl's walking up to the green to try and get a better idea of where he should be landing this. Yes, landed into a bit of an upslope there, which killed it a bit, but that's not bad. Never really had the pace, so everyone in this group's taking bogey on this hole. Right, Carl's found the bunker, so that's taken out getting to the green in two because he's relatively close to the front edge, the front lip, so he's just going to have to cut his losses here. Oh my god, he's hooked it. There's a ton of fairway out there. I think that might be in a spot of bother. I think Carl's going to run this up, land it short and run it up. It's hitting off the pine needles, so he's got to make sure he keeps the acceleration going. He thought about it, just didn't get quite as much of a kick as he thought, but he's got that for birdie, so at least it takes bogey out of the equation. Going for his birdie is probably ruining the fact that he used driver off the tee. Oh, good putt. So he made a complete meal out of the hole but still walked off with par, so should still walk off the par. Well, on the second of the par threes. Carl's got a good record on this hole. He actually played his par threes in even yesterday for the first time for a while. Seems to like that. Yeah, that's alright. There's a lot of wind up there. These pine trees are protecting the wind from hitting us a lot, but you can probably hear it on the microphone. There's a lot of wind up above the trees. Good putt, really good putt. Left it right on the lip again. Good shot. That should still find the fairway. Yeah, that's fine. He's used a club that wouldn't bring the problems into play, so it's a smart play. Covering his second shot, it's 110 yards out. He likes this. Yeah, he's not happy about it though. Well, Karl wasn't happy with his approach shot, but he's 15 feet directly under the hole. And the one place you couldn't miss was above the hole, because the hole is actually on a downslope, which I find hard to understand, because it's going to slow down play and bring a lot of three putts into play. But where Karl's put it is pretty much 9 out of 10. Anyone that's above the hole will not be able to stop that ball. Reasonable look at birdie here, but there's going to be a lot of missed short putts with that pole position today. It's literally on the downslope. Gotta hit it, Chief. Gotta hit it. Gotta hit it. Right in the jaws. Couple of those is left right in the jaws. Carl's pulling out the driver on this dog leg left. Oh, it's gone a bit right on him, making the second shot longer when he actually wanted it to go left. Carl's put himself into a bit of a pickle here. That was his third shot, because his drive went right and his recovery shot hit a tree and put him back out to 160, and he's put that one about 15 feet right of the pin that you can see right on the edge there. So he's got that to save par. That's three holes you've left it short. I've got a dog leg left, and Carl's taking it to the very right edge of the tee box to increase his angle. This is pure. That should be straight over the corner, if he's got the right angle. And he's gone over the back of this green. He's on the pine straw over the back of the green. He's played a decent recovery shot up, but he's got that putt there for par on greens that are very bumpy.
Fine.
This to save par. He's hit the middle of the fairway there, so he's gonna give himself about 100 yards to the green there. Needs to keep it right in the hole. He likes that. Oh yeah, that'll do. That'll do. Carl's only got a foot and a half on this birdie. Really good approach wedge there. After a birdie on the 9th, Carl slips up to the 10th. Yeah, it's going a little bit left, but it should be fine. Yeah, he's alright there. You're hitting into a straight into a strong headwind here. The car's in a reasonable position, about 120 out. They're heading straight into the breeze off the tee. He's on a downslope, but he knows how to deal with that. Yeah, good shot. Under the hole. They'll need about three putts on the condition of this green, because I've just watched the group in front and they all three putted this green. Very, very bumpy, and the pin again is on a slope. Right, Carl's got about 15 feet. There is a ton of left to right break because the hole is actually on a slope. So this will be a fun ride. You're kidding. Caught something and just wouldn't drop. Good effort. Carl probably hit that a lot harder than he thought he even needed to. That still wouldn't drop. Carl steps up to the 11th tee. Into the breeze. Likes that. Carl can't get there in two, so he's only got a four driving iron in hand here. He's going to be into the wind. This is going to be hit about 190 and leave him about 100 short of the hole. Likes that. Yep, middle of the fairway, 100 out. Right, Carl was aiming to leave that shot 100 out, and that's the 100 yard. Red 100 yard placard just next to his pushcart there. So he's hit his mark. And the wind's coming off the right. Yeah, it's really gusty now. You can probably hear it in the microphone a bit. So he's going to have to start this a little bit right of the flag. Yeah, that wind's just killed that. You can't see it with the flag, but the wind's really gusty above the treetops here. And the wind just killed it. But two putts for par, one putt for birdie. Oh, good putt. Just shaved the top lip. These greens are very bumpy. Boys are shaking their heads at these greens. Taking that, cutting a bit of the corner off the dog leg there. Right, here's the reason Carl wasn't too happy about his drive. He was trying to put a baby cut on it to take it over the corner of the pine trees on the dog leg, but his drive actually held its line and stayed straight, so he's in the rough, but he's got a pretty good lie there. He likes this. Yeah, under the hole, about 10 feet. Carl for birdie on the 12th. Has it got the legs? It's another one short. That's five he's left short of the hole.
A problem I had with the putting was I usually play on greens that run at about 12 or 13, but this week they were running at 9. I couldn't quite adjust to it, but I understood that they were slow. Like, when I look at the putt, I know it's going to be really slow. But then when I hit it, I changed my mind for some reason, and I just hit it short. I had left 7 putts short in the second round. So That cost me. A couple of them were right in the jaws. Would have made birdies.
Right, so the play's been caught up on the par 3 third bank. Oh, that'll work. Yeah, you can work with that. Carl's got about 7 feet for his birdie. He should break right to left about one cup. That's a beauty. That ball hasn't budged an inch from the middle of the fairway. Carl's driver split the middle. He's only got 90 yards left to the flag. I don't think he's hit that. No, he hasn't.
That's how I've been swinging my wedges in this tournament. Using my body too much, but I became really reliant on that, but it wasn't really working because I was not accurate and I wasn't hitting wedge shots that I should have hit close, like 70 yard shots. I was missing the green, which I really don't usually do, but I wasn't missing them by much, but I was just using more of my body than my arms, and I was hitting them low. I wasn't getting great contact most of the time. So what I'm doing to fix that is I'm just gonna drop the club on the ball without using, obviously I gotta use my body to rotate, but just using my arms a little bit more, it gets it higher and creates more spin. And that's what I've been working on today. So this is what it should look like with the arms. Now, I was actually swinging like that last year, but somehow in the mix of everything, all the changes, it's just, that faded away from me, and that's how I created the body twist, or the too much rotation in my swing. But now that I'm away from all that stuff, and I'm gonna restart this new summer, I'm doing what I was doing last year, because it worked good for me. I won 2 majors, and it seemed to work then, so why can't I do it now?
Well, Carl's left himself with a bit of work today. Yeah, good shot. Right, Carl is safe. Yeah, going back to his wedge shot. It's very windy out here now, and I think he was expecting the wind to carry that shot. He only misses mark by about a yard. That's a bogey. Just getting a little bit too cheeky with his approach shot. Right, Carl's in the beach. I would be asking that other player to mark his ball, because that other ball could stop Carl's getting into the cup. Looks like Carl's not going to ask him. I'd be insisting that it get marked. Good shot. They hit it firm. If you hit it soft, you'll miss it. Well done. On the 16th, Carl's run back from the overall lead. Needs a good drive. Not entirely happy with it, but he's okay. Be on the right half of the fairway. This is index 1, this hole. It's a 444-yard par 4. Oh, he's missed it. Oh no, he's hit the green. But he's really after birdies, not pars. That's got a very long way. birdie putts, probably about 30 feet. Over a lot of very rough green. See that ball bouncing away. Yeah, well, when the ball's bouncing like that, it takes all the speed off. Right, Carlston with 4 feet left to save his par. Hope he doesn't miss this, otherwise he's going to explode. He missed it. That's the end of his into play. You can still birdie this if you just hit 3 wood wedge. All three boys have come up short. All three. Alright, Carl's got to hold this ball. To have any chance. Oh, good effort. Really good effort. So shall we practice this?
Desperately needs birdie on the last hole. The wind has just come up. He has overhooked that. He's hitting into the wind and he's hooked it. So there's nothing else can really happen except that. Keep on hooking.
Carl's ball is sitting in mud. Just pure mud. You'll see that it was covered in mud. It's not allowed to clean it unless it's on the fairway.
Make sure you guys stick around after the video to see me being presented with the Tarheel Tour MVP and Player of the Year awards.
This is for a 5. This is not a good back 9.
My swing felt the best and looked the best that it's ever looked. My putting stroke looked the best to me. I feel like when I watched the videos that my whole game was the best that I've seen it. It's just my driving cost me and my mind wasn't in the right place. But leaving the putt shorts, you probably heard my dad going crazy about that for good reason. It drove me crazy too. But it was hard to adjust to those really slow greens. But next week I'm gonna come back strong. Hopefully those greens are running faster. My putting stroke isn't the problem, it was just my speed. But other than that, I played pretty good.
The most valuable player. The most valuable player is a person who wins the most amount of money. Okay? And the player of the year is the one who has the lowest stroke average. Okay? So we give 2 for the freshman sophomore, 2 for the junior senior. Fortunately, the junior senior players are not here this weekend, but the freshman sophomore division for the entire year, okay,
the winner for the, well, for both trophies was Kangaroo Karl. Yes, Kangaroo Karl. Well, it says God Pride, we're in that 2015 God Pride Player of the Year. Hold on, let's see. Hold on.
Most valuable player.
Okay. And the other one's Player of the Year. Karl won, let's see. He won $17 million this year. So that'll help him out a little bit down that road. And his stroke average, I think it's pretty impressive because one thing about Karl, he doesn't pick and choose. I mean, if it's raining, he plays. If it's whatever the weather is, he's out there playing. So all year, he averaged 73.7. And especially since when he started this year, he was only 13, maybe? Yeah, 13. So he's going to be in this division for a long time. So I know you didn't finish the way you wanted to. I know it hurts, but overall, you came out a big winner for the year. Congratulations.